Hey guys, what is going on? This is Pedro from Music by Pedro. Today we're going to talk about a clarinet mini lesson. We're going to cover two very, very important things. The first one is your clarinet posture, and the second one is finger placement. Let's talk about clarinet posture. If you are standing up or sitting down, your body should be straight up, like so, and the clarinet in your mouth should be at about a 45 degree angle, so something like this. Okay, 45 degree angle. Very, very simple thing to remember, but it's one that we take for granted. We get a lot of people that kind of bring the horn down just a little bit too much. And the sound gets really, really pinched, and that becomes a problem. If it's too high, it's too bright, and we can't control it, okay? So 45 degree angle definitely is the best place, whether you're sitting down or standing up. If you're sitting down on a chair, make sure that you're sitting on the front half of the chair with your feet flat on the floor. I cannot accentuate that enough because people don't do it, and then their sound changes so much because they're slouching, they got feet crossed, and that causes bad circulation, and it's just all kinds of mess. Just remember, keep it simple, keep it relaxed. Sitting on the front half of the chair, feet flat on the floor, clarinet at a 45 degree angle, okay? Let's talk about finger placement now. Now, finger placement, I'm gonna go through each finger basically and tell you exactly where it should go and why, okay? Some people tell you to just do stuff. You know me, I like to tell you why, and I usually will give you an example of what happens if you don't, okay? So let's start with the thumb. You don't just wanna do the thumb so that it covers the back hole. You wanna make sure that the thumb covers the back, but it also has a reach to the register key. If not, our thumb's gonna be dancing up and down, it's gonna make us very sluggish, and we're not gonna be able to play very fast. So keep it so that it covers the back hole and is also in contact with that register key. That's gonna be your thumb. Your first finger is also super, super important because it plays two functions. It plays the E key here, and it also plays the A key. What I tell my students to do whenever they go from E to A is to not lift the finger like that, but instead roll, roll. And that's gonna make that A open up nice and clean. So E to A, not E to A. We don't want that jumping. We don't need our fingers jumping. We got enough going on. Let's not add jumping to the mix, okay? Second finger is gonna go pretty simple right there on that second hole. Third finger is gonna close there. Now let's talk about our fingers and what part of your finger you actually use to close these fingers. As you know, the clarinet is an open hole instrument. So it's very important that we use a specific part of our fingers. We cannot use the tips alone to close the holes because we're gonna get improper seal, then we're gonna get all kinds of funky notes. Some notes won't come out, and it's gonna be an issue. Here's what I tell. I'm gonna press my fingers really, really hard against the finger so you guys can see what part of the finger I actually use to play the clarinet. Give me just a second here. Oh, there we go. You can see the circles on my fingers. That is the part of your finger that you wanna use. There we go, right there. If you use your tips, you're gonna probably run your fingernails along the hole. Again, it's not gonna create a proper seal, and it's definitely gonna be an issue. So use kind of the side of your finger. You still want your fingers curved, but you definitely wanna use the side of your finger to seal each hole, okay? Let's go back to finger two on the left hand. It's gonna go just like that. It's gonna seal nice and clean there. Pinky, I always tell people to rest it on the, I'm trying to think where I normally rest it. I normally rest it on these two bottom keys here. I try not to get too wrapped up into these two, the alternate keys here, but rather these two bottom keys. That's definitely where they rest. So when I'm playing, yeah, that's gonna be my natural position. Fingers, you want them to be nice and curved, as if you're holding a ball in your hand, imaginary ball, nice and relaxed. If you hold them to the side of your hand, they're gonna be nice and relaxed, which is bringing the hand up just like that, okay? So that's the left hand for you. Right hand, your thumb is gonna go right underneath the thumb hook back here, just like that. And then you've got first finger, second finger, third finger. I have a habit of resting my pinky on the low F key, right there. And then making sure, again, all the fingers are nice and curved, nice and relaxed, no pressure. Keep the fingers parallel to the ground, okay? Very, very important that we do that. So with the posture and with the right finger technique, you're gonna eliminate and prevent so many bad habits. Guys, I cannot stress this enough. If you have any question about any of the things that I just mentioned, leave it in the comments below. Obviously, as always, if you're going to have any questions about the embouchure, I did make a video and I'm going to put it right there so you guys can check it out, okay? That is basically it, guys. Thank you, as always. You guys are awesome for watching. If you enjoyed this video, you want more clarinet videos, definitely drop a like below. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.